I can go to display, statement of accounts, outstanding, and receivables, payables. So this is what my suppliers, these are all payables. If I just click on payables, it will show me all the payables for all the groups. So it is also showing for other parties, Vikram Landlord, Vikram Distributor, Nandan Electronics. So you could look at here, the bill wise it is showing, three bills are showing, 31,000 is pending, 90,000 is pending, 1,51,000 is pending. Or I could also go to outstanding and say ledger wise for Vikram Distributors. See here, there are four bills. So here it is much more clear, which says the date of the bill, reference, opening amount. The bill amount was 4,18,000, but currently pending amount is 2,85,000. So the balance has already been adjusted. Okay, and it is also showing you what is the due date. By 18th April, it should have been paid. And today we are on 5th of June. So it is 48 days overdue. You are able to understand this? So now my bill amount was 4,18,000. I have made some partial payments. Currently 2,85,000 is pending. The due date was 18th of April. And it is overdue by 48 days. Like that, you will get for each of the bills. Right? Now, if I want to know, when did I receive this difference of this amount? When did we receive this money? Nagraj is asking, can we get paid details also in reports? Yes. Nagraj, what we are seeing, this is a report only. Okay, so in the bill wise details over here, this is my bill value, this is my pending amount, due date and number of days. Now if I want to know when was this adjusted, so I could just click on F1 detailed. It will show me the detailed value. See here, the purchase was made on 8th of April for 4,18,000. We made on payment on 30th of May, 1,30,000. We made one more payment on 5th of June, 3,000 rupees. So on 4,18,000 credit, I have 1,30,000 and 3,000 rupee debits. So it is just nullifying and giving me the net of value that is still pending. Is this clear? Krishna Prasad, you need to check your computer for audio. I think most of the participants are getting. So I request you to check on your audio, please. Okay. So here, once when we look at this, this is also giving me the complete breakup. Nagraj, I'll come back to you. I'm not able to understand your problem, your question. I'll come back to you. Okay. Is this clear? The bill wise, which is showing me. Okay, now, so for every party, I could just go to report and I could look at the reports. Okay, so display, statement of accounts, outstanding, payable. Okay, or ledger wise. So now Vikram is calling me every day saying, sir, 5,57,000 is pending. Please make the payment, sir. Okay, it's overdue by 48 days. Okay, if you continue to do this, we'll not be able to supply. All those discussions are happening. Now, what is going to happen is, see, generally, let me tell you how the business works. So the business works like this. We purchase from our suppliers. Generally, we pay on time. Okay, few occasions we don't pay because for various reasons. Probably I am not able to collect from my customer. I have a cash flow problem. Okay, I have paid my bonus to all my employees. So this month there is a cash flow problem. So I want to hold some of the payments. All those things are happening in the normal business. But what is going to happen is, example, in this case, even Vikram has to run his business, right? So he is always looking at, okay, from where can I collect this money? From where can I collect this money? So what I will do is, once when I look at this, okay, Vikram, I need to pay 5.57 lakhs. Okay, let me do one thing, man. Just clear one bill. I'm just telling my accounts department, saying that, okay, clear one bill or clear two bills. So there is a very simple way to do that. Rather than going to voucher entry like this and making the payment, okay, we can go to display statement of accounts, outstanding, ledger, go to that specific ledger. Okay, this is one way of looking at the report. The second way of looking at the report, I'll also show you one more way of looking at the report. Display accounts book ledger, not the outstanding. Display accounts book ledger and go to Vikram distributors. So this is where I'm getting his ledger details. Here also I could just click on bill wise. So now it's taking me to the same report. So on the same report, I'm able to view the bill wise details. All right. So there are multiple different ways that you could go. So now example, okay, I will tell my accounts team boss, okay, clear this one bill. Let me look at the other ones. Clear this 31,000. Okay. So now the simple way to do is, rather than escaping, going to my voucher entry and doing everything, I have an option here to bill settlement. I could just click on this bill settlement, select which are all the bills I want to settle, and just click on bill settlement. Okay, so it'll ask for the voucher date. Example, I'll just say 8th of June from HDFC Bank, narration. Bill cleared, and say yes. So now it has automatically populated my payment entry. So this payment entry is done. I could just say control A and accept it. The payment is done. Is that right? So now if I just go on to the date and say, see here, now there is no bill wise details that's available for this transaction. So is this clear? Okay, so there is one question from Jyoti. If Vikram Distributors has some party who is my sundry debtors, can I settle my payments with Vikram Distributors? Madam, I'm not able to understand your question. Okay, so if you want, I can unmute you. If you could just help me understand what is your question so that we could understand. I'm not able to understand the question. If Vikram Distributors has some party who is sundry debtors, can I settle my payments with Vikram Distributors? Madam, would you like to explain your question? I'm not able to understand your question. Okay, I'll just unmute you. Just hold on. Yeah, Jyoti, can you hear us?
Yeah. Hello, sir.
Yeah. Yes, madam. What's your question? I'm not able to understand your question.
Sir, Vikram Distributors is my creditor, sir.
Correct.
Okay. And that Vikram Distributors has got another creditor. Who is my debtor?
Vikram Distributor?
As another creditor.
Currently, he's our creditor. He is my supplier.
He is my supplier, sir.
Correct.
He has got another supplier, sir.
He has got one more supplier, another and means supplier. We have got one more supplier.
Not we, sir, only Vikram.
Okay, Vikram has one more supplier to whom we are supplying.
To whom? Yeah, right, sir, right.
Okay, so Vikram has, so if I understand it correctly, am procuring from Vikram, I am purchasing from Vikram distributors,
correct,
and I am selling to a customer of Vikram.
Right, sir.
Correct?
Right, sir.
Okay, so I understand from where you are coming from. Okay, so I'll explain what Jyoti is looking for. Okay, so what they do is, I think they are into paperboard business, correct?
Okay, sir. Yeah.
Yeah. So what they do is, okay, they get orders from their from various customers. Okay, so they procure from the manufacturer. So example, they procure from ITC, they procure from South India Paper Mills. Okay, but what these manufacturers are saying is, okay, you please deliver these products to my customers. Okay, so actually what happens is the load in the lorry which is picked from the ITC or the South India Paper Mills is directly moved to my customer place. But the purchase bill will come to me. I'm raising on sales bill.
Right.
Is it correct?
Right, sir. Right.
Okay. Yeah. Now what happens? What Jyoti is asking. So now I need to pay, example, 10 lakh rupees to ITC. But I need to collect 5 lakh rupees, 7 lakh rupees from the customer who is actually not my customer. He is ITC's customer.
Right, sir. Right.
So in that case, madam, yes, you can do it. You need to pass a JV. So you need to pass a JV and reduce the balance of ITC. Sorry, reduce the balance of your customer and increase the balance of your ITC. Okay. Yeah. Okay. So let's move on. Okay. So this is one thing that you could do. And second thing on this report, whatever the things that we are looking at, you see now, critical thing is, okay, I need to collect 5.26 lakhs. It's already 51 days. One bill is 51 days old. One bill is 38 days old. One bill is 24 days old, overdue. Okay, so here you also have age-wise details. Example, if you just click on this age-wise, okay, you could say age by bill date or due date. Say example, I'm saying age by due date. Okay, I want to see all the balance which is less than 15 days, 15 to 30 days, 30 to 45 days, 45 to or 45 days and above. Once when you do this report, you are able to get what is the balance which is less than 15 days, overdue less than 15 days. There is zero. Between 15 to 30 days, it is 1.51 lakhs. Between 30 to 45 days, it is 90,000. And more than 45 days, which is 2.85 lakhs. So what this gives me an understanding is, typically when I look at my receivables, okay, from whom I need to collect my money, I know where my money is struck and how long it is struck. Say example, if you take in this case, out of 5.26 lakh, 2.85 lakhs is more than 45 days old. So 50% of the outstanding is more than 45 days old. So this is one of the most effective, powerful report that you could see. All right. Okay. So let me do one thing. Similarly, you could do the same thing for your sales also. Okay. Before we get into sales, let me say if I want to account one advance. So today I have got one new supplier. I need one product, new supplier. So the supplier doesn't know me. So he's asking me, Mahesh, if you only give advance, we will supply the material. Otherwise, we're not going to supply. So I need to pay him 10,000 rupee advance. So let us just look at how to do the transaction. Say example, I'm just on 10th of June. So I need to make a payment to a new supplier who is Anuradha Consultancy Services. So they are my suppliers. Okay. So I need to pay them 10,000 rupee advance. I'm making 10,000 rupee and accounting it as advance. So voucher number itself is taken as the bill number. Okay, and I'm saying this should we should get the supplies, okay, within next 4 or 5 days, and I want to adjust within next 5 days, example, or next 10 days. Okay, so by 20th June, the material should come, and I need to adjust this bill. Okay, so I'm just accounting this. I've paid through check, being advance paid. Okay, so now I made the payment. Okay, so let me say by 20th, they supplied me the product. Okay, and they have given me the invoice also. So I need to account it as purchase. Okay, so I'll go to purchase and I'm changing the date to 20th. Okay, so supplier has given along with his invoice number. So Anuradha Consultancy Services. I'm just taking as local purchase. Okay, so item. So for sample purpose, I'm just creating one item, call it as what they are supplying me. Let me take one product, books. Okay, so they have supplied me books. Okay, so 50 books. Okay, each book costing 400 rupees. 20,000 rupees is the bill. Now when I'm accounting this, so now I have already paid an advance of 10,000 rupees. First, I need to adjust that advance. So I can go to against reference, click on against reference. So it will show me the bill wise details here. Number 5, 10th June, 10,000 rupee debit balance that's available. So first I will adjust that 10,000 rupees. And the balance I'm adjusting against the new bill. So this new bill, I'm still supposed to pay this bill, right? Because advance I had given only 10,000. Now the bill value is 20,000. So this bill I need to supposed to pay within next 2 days. So I'm just taking 2 days of credit. By 22nd June, I am supposed to pay. Okay, so this is how you adjust. Being purchase bill accounted. Okay, now if I go to display accounts book ledger of Anuradha Consultancy Services. So now there is one payment of 10,000 and purchase of 20,000. Closing balance is 10,000 payable. And if I want to know against which bill this 10,000 is payable, I could just click on bill wise details over here. I'm getting this bill wise details. So 10,000 against the supplier bill number, because another 10,000 was adjusted against advance. Is that clear? And if you just click on shift enter, so here you have. Okay. And you could also do one more thing. You could go to configuration. On this bill wise details, you could just click on configuration and say show bills. Currently, it is just showing only the pending bills. You could say show all bills, then it will show you your advance also. So advance of 10,000, it has got adjusted. Then there is one more purchase balance of 10,000 rupees, which is pending. Is this clear? So I made a payment of 10,000 that got adjusted against the purchase bill. And again, there is in one purchase bill, there is 10,000 more I need to pay. So this is how you could account the advance and do the adjustments. Hope this gives the clarity on how to account the advances. Is this clear? Okay, so let's just look at okay, good. So let us just look at The next option. Right. So the next option is basically, if I don't want to track, say example, I'm making one 5,000 rupee payment to Vikram Distributors. Okay, so Ganesh from Fine Tunes is saying, how do you make this bill wise details enabled? Okay, for our office related expenditures like electricity bill, water bill, some expenses that we are doing, we are incurring, okay, service charges that we are paying, because currently whatever I'm discussing is on purchase, this thing. So the same thing works on your any type of voucher, even on a journal. So once when you want to account the expense, you are generally accounting the expense on journals, right? Journal entry. Even on the journal entry, you could do that. So I will show it to you how to do that on journal entry. Ganesh, thanks for reminding me this. Okay, we will take this example and I'll just show it to you. Okay. So now let me just take one more example I'm just showing. Okay, so I'm making one payment to, on 21st, I'm making one cash payment to Vikram Distributors. So example, I'm just paying him 5,000 rupees. Now, I don't want to adjust against any of these bills. Okay, because this 5,000 I'm saying, boss, okay, it is between me and Vikram Distributors. Okay, he had just told boss, give me 5,000. I'm just making him from 5,000 payment. And I don't want to track this anywhere. In that case, just use on account. So it will not even ask you the bill wise details, anything. Okay. Payment made. Okay, so I just made one 5,000 rupee payment. Now, when I go to display, accounts book, ledger, and say Vikram Distributors. So there is one cash payment for 5,000. And if I go to bill wise details, this 5,000 is not got adjusted against any bill. It is available separately as on account. Or there might be some confusion today for me. Okay, so there is some dispute between me and Vikram. Okay, so I have told Vikram saying that, okay, I'm making this 5,000 payment. Let us figure it out to which bill it has to be adjusted and the later date. I'm just doing one ad hoc payment. In those cases, we could use on account. Okay, so on account will be available for all the parties, even if the bill wise details are enabled. Okay. So now let us just move on to what Ganesh was asking for. Okay. So now I need to account some expenditures. Okay. So now today morning electricity bill has come. So I need to account this electricity bill, but they have given me 10 days time to make the payment. So first I need to account the bill. So the electricity bill has come. The bill number is 31245. Okay. On 21st of June. Debit electricity expense. I don't have this ledger, so I'm just creating one ledger. Alt C is for creation of ledger. Electricity expenses. It is under indirect expense or direct expense as it is. So generally for expenditures, I don't need bill wise details. I need bill wise details only for my suppliers and customers. Okay, so I'm just disabling this. Say example, I'm just saying 540 rupees is my electricity bill. Credit is I need to pay to BESCOM. Okay, so BESCOM is not there. I'm just creating BESCOM as the ledger, which typically comes under sundry creditors. Bill wise details, yes. Okay, 540. Now I have this bill wise details. Account this bill number, it is just picking. Within 10 days, I'm supposed to pay before 1st of July. I need to make this payment. So this bill wise adjustment is available in all accounting vouchers. It's available on your journal, it's available on your purchase, it's available on your sale, it's available on your payment, it's available on your receipt. On all the accounting vouchers, bill wise adjustments are available. It's available on your debit note and credit notes also. Okay, so now I need to make a payment, FI payment, say example on 4th of July. So now I need to make a payment to BESCOM. So I'm paying in cash. So as soon as I click on BESCOM, it is showing me 540 is the balance. So I'm paying all the 540 against reference. It will automatically come. So I could know the list. I could select against which bill I'm making the payment. Right? Being electricity expenses paid. Hope it's clear now. Okay, now one more thing before we get into the reports. Okay, similarly, we could follow the same example for my sales also, sales and income also. So example, I'm making a credit sale to Royal Agencies. Okay, so hopefully Royal Agencies is my, okay, they are my debtors. Okay, I'm selling them Annapurna Atta, 100 kgs. Okay, quantity is, okay, 40 kgs at 35 rupees per kg, 1400. Okay, now this 1400, bill number 4, I'm giving him 5 days of credit, example. Okay, so again, I'm just making one more transaction on 5th of July to same Royal Agencies. So he has bought 20 books at 500 rupees per book. Okay, so this is just 5 days of credit. Okay, so as you start making this transaction, okay, the same will be available as your in outstanding as receivables. So all money which I need to get from my customers are under receivables. Okay, so you are getting this Royal Agencies 1400 and 10,000 rupees. Okay, you could also see Anand Traders 20,000, 10,000, which is 96 days old. By 31st May, I should have got. Today, we are on 5th of July. It is 96 days old. Okay, so some of the things are coming as opening balance figures, which are 96 days old. And there are some of my sales also. Now, when I look at my complete receivables, in this screen, you are seeing all parties at one shot. Okay. Or you could go to payables. Payables will show you for all parties in one screen. What is the total payable? Okay. Or if you want only specific ledgers. Okay. Specific party you want to go and say example, BESCOM. BESCOM is zero because the whatever the bill we have accounted, we have made the payment. So outstanding is zero. Okay. Similarly, if you want to go to Royal Agencies and see, it is just showing you only the bills of Royal Agencies. Okay. Is this clear? Yeah. So what I will do is I will just log into one sample data. Okay. Which has more transactions where transaction is already built in so that we could look at reports and see how it will how to read these reports. So example, I'm just taking one company name, receivables and payables management. Okay, so typically this is the data, okay, which is 1 year data is available. Okay, so now we'll use this data for reporting purpose, for checking the reports. Okay, Vikram, Trivikram has a question. How come ledgers are only few parties where payables and receivables are too many? Trivikram, one single party might have multiple bills. So one party might have 100 bills. One party might have only one bill. Okay, so there is no restriction with number of bills to parties. So once when you go and look at the party, you will have less number of parties. But once when you go and look at the bill wise details, you might have more bill wise details. Because one party, I would have billed him multiple times. And most of the bills might be pending. So there is no correlation between number of parties and number of bills. Okay, it depends from business to business. Okay, so now let me just go to a separate data. Okay, I wanted to just use this data for reporting purpose. So now let me just take you to the reporting, display, statement of accounts, outstanding. If I just click on outstanding and click on receivables. Okay, I can just show you. I have so many receivables in my books. These are all the receivables I need to receive money from different parties, or still some adjustments needs to be done. I have not done the adjustments. Okay, and it is overdue by 600 days, 400 days, 80 days, 20 days, various details that you can look at over here. Okay, one beauty of this is when I'm looking at receivables, typically what I want to know is, okay, while I have 2.72 lakhs of receivables, first thing that I need to know as a businessman is, boss, from where can I collect this money? Who will give me how much money? Is that what very important for you people? Do you all agree? I don't know who is owning how much of money, but I need to talk to these people and start collecting the money. So what I'm going to do is very simple. In this report, I have an option where I can go to this report and click on party wise, bill party wise details. Once when I click on bill party wise details, this report is getting consolidated party wise details. So from which party, how much money I need to receive? Say example, Akshay Kalpa. Okay, so there is some balance that I need to receive. Okay, there is some tedious bills that I need to get. Tedious adjustments, something needs to happen. Some GST money I need to get. Okay, so similarly for each party, okay, it will give me party wise, bill wise adjustments. Okay, so some pay you I need to get from different bills. Okay, so this is how I could look at. Now I know to which party I need to talk to. Okay, so example, I'll show you one more report. Okay, so I need to receive some money from Crystal Credit. So I'm just going to Crystal Credit. So there is some money that I need to receive. Okay, so there is some 24,000 rupee balance that I need to receive. Now whom will I call? How do I make the call? So I should know to whom should I call, right? So I'm seeing this report. Okay, 24,780. So whom should I follow up with? So there is an option on this report. When you go to an outstanding report, you could just click on contact details. Click on this contact details. I get the complete contact details if I have stored this in my part of my master. So here it is telling me contact person is Karthik, his mobile number is available, his email ID is available. All these details are available. Is this handy information for me to call this party to collect money? Do you all believe this is very, very important? Because one is just how much of balance is available. But whom should we call to collect this? Where will we follow up? This is very, very critical information. So what I would recommend all of you is, whenever you create a party, whenever you create your customers, please ensure that you are updating all the fields of the contact details. Right? Okay. So this is one critical information. Second, as I showed you, if you go to receivables and payables, say example payables, if I just go to payables, to whom all I need to pay? All the payables are getting listed out over here. Okay. Again, I could just say party wise, bill wise, it'll give me party wise to whom all I need to pay money. Right. So this is one report that you could look at. Then there is one more report, outstanding group wise. Say example, I want to know the outstanding of all my parties who is in Mysore or who are in typically one geography. If I made that, say example, I can just go to group and say, I want to see the group of all my parties under specific group. Okay, say example, sundry data is Mysore. So what is the money that I'm supposed to receive? So from Satnarayana Plywoods, there is some money that I need to receive. From Siddhi Vinayaka, there is some money that I need to receive or pay, whatever, receive or payment. This is my outstanding receivables and payable management. Here I could again click on bill wise details, party wise, bill wise. It will also give me this party against which bill it is due and how many days it is due. Okay, so this is one effective report from where I could pull the information as to from where I need to collect money. See, you should all understand, cash is the king in the business. If you don't have enough of cash flow, the business will die its natural death. To ensure that we get money in time, the most important thing, if you want to be very successful in business and continue to do businesses, you should collect your money in time. And to build the trust with your business group, you should pay your suppliers in time. Okay, it is not just that you collect money from your customers in time. You should also ensure that you should pay your suppliers in time, because your suppliers are dependent on you. If you don't pay them in time, their business is under risk. Similarly, our business is under risk if we don't collect our payments from our customers in time. So one of the most critical information that you could fetch from Tally is the receivables and payables. Okay, so with my experience of say last 20 years, I've seen a lot of organizations who are using Tally for only receivables and payables management. Okay. Till last few years, I think till 2016-17, Infosys was using Tally to manage the receivables and payables. Though they are on SAP, they complete their finances on SAP, their outstanding management, they used to still manage on Tally, because Tally is one of the fantastic tool for you to manage, especially the receivables and payables. Okay. And some of the other reports that you could get once when you start managing receivables and payables. Okay. Is if you just go to your ratio analysis. See, in the ratio analysis, if you go, okay, there are certain reports, certain information that you will get. Okay, which will be very handy for you once when you look at the report. Say example here, there is receivable turnover in days, payment performance to debtors, which means 1.39 days That is your average collection days, which typically tells you what is your average collection days. And you could go and see your party wise, what is the average collection days it is taking. Okay, so this will give you some indication saying which supplier I'm not able to collect in time. Okay, so this is one of the critical reports. All these things, the information will come only once when you start accounting bill wise details in the proper way. Okay, so now if I just look at this report, okay, which is giving me, okay, I could just say whichever customers who are more than 60 days is my critical problem I need to solve. Or based on your business, you could define how many number of days. So here it is saying using actual bill days, bill dates for clearance. Okay, so some of the customers are 3 days, some of the customers are 13 days, some of the customers are 12 days. Okay, some of the customers are one single day, some of the customers are 60 days. It depends from customer to customer. But what it will give me is an overview of how my collections are working. Okay, where we are failing, which customer is not paying in time. This is one of the critical things that you could know once when you start updating all your bill-wise details in the proper way. Okay. So while you do this, okay, from the reporting perspective, okay, I need to send the outstanding statements to my customers. Say example, most of the business follow that every week they send the outstanding statement to their customers. Every month they send, every day they send. It depends on business to business. So how do we send this outstanding reports to our customers? Say example, I could just say display accounts book ledger. So for specific party, I need to send an outstanding statement. Okay, so let me just take for example. Okay, for this thing. So I'll just say Micromatic Machine Tools. I need to send an outstanding statement details. Okay, so there is probably, okay, one bill which is outstanding. So I need to send this outstanding statement details. Okay, so what I could do is I could just click on email, configure this mail so that the customer mail ID is also automatically picked over here. And if I just say yes, this report goes on an email. Even without you printing, it'll just go on an email. Will this help you? Okay, so this is one way of taking this remainder. I can just show you what information it will go. Okay, you could just enable this. So this is the information which will just send through email. Or if you want to send an outstanding report with the remainder letter, you could just enable remainder letter. Okay, you could say from 0 to 10 days. Okay, I will just make this so that I'll have less number of columns. Designation of the signature authority, co-founder, show contact details. Yes. See here. Okay, it says to Micromatic Machine Tools from contact person, subject outstanding 31st March 20, given below is the detail of outstanding against your name. The bill wise details, we request you to take immediate steps for settling the bills. All right. So this could be automatically mailed even you printing these things. So will this help for managing your outstanding receivables and payables? Okay. So do you have any other questions? So if I just go to my presentation, I think I've covered most of this, which I had in my presentation. new reference, advanced reference, against reference, on account. Hope everyone is clear on all these things. Different build types. Okay. Then we went through bill details, name, due date, by what date it has to be paid, what is the amount, breaking up of the amount value, the bill value to multiple dates. Okay. Then we looked at the outstanding reports, receivables, payables, by ledger, by group. Okay. Then we also looked at F12 configurations. Okay. Age wise, if you want to do age wise, 0 to 30 days, 30 to 60, 60 to 90, or any number of days that you could do. Contact details. How do you pull contact details on the outstanding report? And how do you adjust the bill from the outstanding report itself rather than going to your voucher entry, keying in the voucher? What is the shortcut that's available? You could just go and adjust the bill. Okay, some of the things that we looked at as part of the reports. Right? Okay, so before we take the question and answers, I want to show you one more thing. Once when you go to display, statement of accounts, outstanding, group wise, say example, I'm just taking sundry debtors as my group. Okay, so it is showing me the party wise details. So here what I could also do is, I could just click on here, party, bill party wise. So here it is showing me against the party, how much is pending and which are all the bills. Okay, so this will help me when I talk to these parties. I know, okay, on a bird's eye view. So this, there are two ways this will help me. Once when I sit with my sales team, responsible who are doing the collections. So when I sit with them, I can discuss with them, okay, why this specific party is not paying in time. Okay, what is the issue? Why don't you talk to these people? So this report will help me in my internal MIS meetings, internal MIS for my meeting with my team on how to drive the collections. Is that clear? Okay, so this was one of the reports. Okay, so Ramesh has one question. From morning session, one question, can you show the profit percentage wise report statement one more time? Okay, sure Ramesh, we will take you through that. Okay, so before we take through that, is there any questions on receivables and payables management? So if there are any questions, please type on your chat, or if you want me to open your voice, I can unmute you so that you could ask the question. Hope everyone is clear on this. That's good. Okay, so very good. Okay, fine. So before I get into answering Ramesh's question, okay, I want to just share once more what are all the topics that we will be discussing tomorrow. Tomorrow's topic will be multi-currency in the morning session, which is typically for if you are dealing, if you have suppliers and customers outside the country where you are doing imports and exports. Okay, if you have multi-currency operations, how it could be done. This is one thing that we'll be discussing in the first session. In the second session, we will be discussing, in the evening session, we'll be discussing on budgets and how to track budgets versus actuals in tally. Okay. So these are all the two topics that tomorrow we will cover down the line. Okay, we will, we have already shared. Okay, I'll tell you when that topic will be. So you could wait for that session. So order management topic is on next Sunday. That's on 5th of April. Okay, we will take this question where we'll have the purchase order management and sales order management. Okay, so Ramesh was asking a question saying, okay, how do I see the profitability statement? Okay, so let me just take through the same report, same data, Ramesh. So if I go to display accounts book, sales register. So I have got the sales register over here. Okay, on the sales register, I could just click on show profit. For each of the invoice, it is showing me what is my gross profit and the profit margin. So example, in this first two invoice, first was I think a sale without making any purchase. So there is a 100% margin. In the second invoice, there is some 27% margin, 28,000 rupees. In 3, 4, and 5, there is actually a loss. Okay, so how this loss is coming, I need to see from the system. Okay, I need to look at what was the cost of the purchase and what is the cost of the sale. From there, I'll be able to arrive at. So very simple. Once when you go to display statement of accounts, display accounts book, sales register, you could just click on show profit. Here is one. Okay, so the profit is at the invoice level. Hope I've answered you, Ramesh. Okay, so let's just go back to our presentation. Let me just look at, have we covered everything? Hope I've covered everything. Okay, are there any questions on any topic that we discussed yesterday, today? Okay, so our contact details are available on the screen. You could call any one of us if you need any clarity. Okay, we are always there to help you out. So Asha, Ramesh, I have missed morning and yesterday's classes. Any option to have that? Madam, let me just understand. Let me just talk to my colleagues. Okay, if they can take one session. So please send one email to us. Okay, I'll just share my email ID. Please send one email if anyone wants repeat of the any session. Okay, please send a mail to this. Which session you want to have a repeat? So I'll just talk to my colleagues. If anyone of my colleagues can take you through this. Okay, we'll schedule a time so that you could come on this thing. Okay.